So if we assume that this is the way the forests grow, we have to think that it will take up to 650 years to get to a point where even the shrubs develop, and non-brittle areas are even worse. They may not even come to this point. And what cows have done for us is to decrease this point to 6 or 7 years. Because you already see in this one what happened. Started in 2011, we started on this land. We kept cows and now it has trees. You can go and see that. And this has happened within 7 years. And that is because it is a brittle environment and we have managed it with cows. That is how it has happened. And that is why we venerate cows. Because the succession can go much faster with cows in a brittle environment than anything else. How much ever compost you put, first of all, to grow that much compost is nearly impossible. And then no disturbance, how will you disturb it in such a easy manner? So that only cows can do for us. So I'm going to come to the third point now, water on the farms. I'm just going to show you a picture of, we are all familiar with the water cycle. That is my next one. So the water from the rain comes and some of it is evaporated from surfaces. Some just runs off your land. Some of it is surface evaporation, some of it is transpiration. If there are plants there, some water transpires. And some then penetrates deeper crevices and fills up the groundwater reservoirs. And this is what we are taking as our irrigation water. But the problem now has become, we all know there is a water problem in India as well as the world. The main problem that is coming out is that number one, we are tilling the land. More and more land is coming under tilling. This is the surface of the land, and when you till it, the microorganisms die in this area because they are baked to death. Of the sunlight. If there is no, do you know what mulch is? When you mulch an area, you are covering it with something. You are covering it either with organic matter or with plastic or something. And you are preventing that atmosphere, that water from escaping as surface evaporation. But when we cut down trees and we take out mulch to make the land bare, we are baking all of those microorganisms. Not only that, we are forming a crust on this soil. Why does the crust happen? Because evaporation is very high in areas which are brittle. Because of course there is more, there are times when there is no humidity from rain, and at that time the evaporation is so high that all of the salts that are mixed in with the water, they remain on the soil and the water evaporates. Once the water evaporates, it leaves a crust. Now what do you do with the crust? The water, when it starts raining again, the crust doesn't allow the water to go in. And all of that water starts to just go as well. For that, another thing that is happening is we are putting all these urea, all of the urea that we are putting on the land is a salt too. So we are making our soil even more salty, and that itself is producing a crust. violent